basically go to your mosque, you pray, you have all these, like, you know, requirements or whatever it's called to do. But you're missing the point. No one can give you evidence, and God is not going to give you evidence for you to have, like, total peace of mind. It's not about understanding everything. It's about your heart. I believe my God is love. Like, love, not human love. Real unconditional love.
Unconditional love?
Yes.
Oh, my God. So you did not read the verse in Psalms 5. And you did not understand about God.
You did not understand. I told you Psalms is on the Old Testament. Jesus Christ has established the New Testament. I am not under, you are not under.
No, wait. You also agreed that in the end days, he'll come and kill his enemies.
Yes, because it's written in the Bible. It's written in Revelation that Jesus...
So that's conditional, right?
No, it's not conditional.
So he'll just kill them?
You don't understand.
Are you saying he'll just kill them?
No, he's not.
Why would he kill them?
Because they have not accepted Jesus Christ.
That is a condition.
No, it's not. Man, he did everything for you.
It's the condition.
Do you know what condition means?
Let me ask you something.
No, don't change the topic. Do you know what condition
means?
Condition
means you have to do something in order
exactly.
to get
Exactly. So those people, the reason you said that they will not be killed is because they rejected Jesus.
Did they
reject Jesus? Yes. Will they be killed because they... So rejecting Jesus or accepting Jesus, this is what your life depends on at the end times.
Yes.
And this is something that we as Muslims also believe, that the end time is the punishment for the people who reject God. And we Muslims say it is conditional. God's love is conditional. God's wrath is conditional. It is not unconditional. So do not say something that is not in the Bible.
We're not talking. I said God loves you unconditionally. Even if you go to hell, he loves you.
No.
Yes.
The reason he loves you, it is conditional. Are you saying that if you reject Jesus, he'll love you?
Yes, but I'm still going to hell.
Oh my God.
Wait. So what does love mean?
He loves you, man.
If you love someone, would you burn them?
No, God is holy, right? But salvation is about being.
No, wait. But you said God loves them even if you sin.
Huh?
Okay. Would God burn someone that He loves?
You don't understand salvation. Salvation is about holiness. God is holy. I told you before. I told you that religion. The problem is with religion. That you can be the best on the cell. You can be the holiest, whatever. You can still not reach God. You cannot get to Him. Only you. Only Jesus is the perfect Lamb who had to die for you in order for you to be able to have a communion and relationship with God. The salvation is about this. It's not about God loves you or not. Yes, He loves you. The Bible says that He died for you while you were a sinner.
No, you went on a whole lecture about something I didn't ask you.
Because
you went on a preaching mode when I asked you. Does God love someone that He's going to burn?
Yeah.
So what's the meaning of love then?
I already explained to you. It's about
I think you're confused about even the meaning of love. The one that you keep mentioning so many times, you even misunderstand that meaning. Because love is something that you have an affection for, someone that whom you, that this person you're loving for, you care for, you have an affection for.
Yeah.
The last thing a person would think about is burning that person in hell or anywhere else.
So basically, you're making it sound like you're better than God.
No, I'm not.
Yes?
Actually, you're the one saying that God's love is unconditional. You're trying to twist God's judgment when saying that His love is unconditional. His love and wrath both are conditional, both in the Bible and in the Quran, and both in the Old Testament, New Testament, and the Quran as well.
So what's the condition? There's one condition to unconditional love. What is it? What is it that God has to give to you in order for
nothing
you?
Nothing that God has promised you is unconditional. Everything that God has promised you is conditional. Even the punishment is conditional. The reward is conditional.
Answer my question. What is the condition to unconditional love?
There's no such thing as unconditional love.
Yes.
Even for human beings,
even
for God, there's no such thing as unconditional love. Because unconditional love, what
there
it means is you
no
turn
love.
A blind eye to everything that person
can
does and you just love him. I did.
No.
Because your question is basically a non-question.
Yeah.
You're saying an unconditional love is something that is illogical and something that neither the Bible nor the Quran advocates.
Like basically there is love and there is no love. We call it, humans call it.
No, there is something called love and there's something called hate.
No.
The opposite of love is hate. Do you not agree?
Oh my gosh.
Are you going to show me a single verse from the Bible where God says that His love is unconditional? Because I've shown you a place in the Bible where God hates the wicked, the wrongdoers,
you agreed with it.
Wait. Every time you bring...
Look,
with all due respect, every time you have brought up the evidence, it is something that you assume up here.
No, I don't.
Yes,
you know it's here.
Okay, again, look, whether it's here or it's here, it is from you.
We need that from the book.
It's not from the Bible.
No.
So why can't you show me from the Bible then?
What you need is evidence.
Show me from the Bible the evidence.
Why do you need evidence to believe like that? Like, why do you
Because I don't believe in blind faith. That's why.
I'm not believing in blind faith.
You are. You said it's here or it's here.
No.
That is blind faith.
No. I explained to you the creation, which is in the Bible, right?
Show me anywhere in the Bible where God advocates unconditional love.
Look, you really just...
Is that a yes or a no? Do you know the words?
Look,
We are not discussing the same Bible. Because all you're doing is it's here. What does here mean? You know, this is exactly what the Pharisees used to do. Because whenever they were asked questions, they used to give their own understanding, their own whims and fancies. And this is what Jesus protested against. And he calls them snakes and vipers. And this is what Jesus always basically rebuked them about. Because they used to do the same thing like the lady, with all due respect. This is what you're doing. You're saying it's here. It's here. That's not how it works. It should be in the book.
Look, he's trying to understand God with your brain, and you don't want to accept that.
Why would you not use your brain?
I never said he's not alive. You might use.
You know what God says in the Bible? He says, "Love your God with all your heart."
Yeah.
Yes, with all your soul.
Keep Old Testament.
Have you got a problem with the Old Testament?
Yes.
You put it under the bus.
No.
You said Jesus was under the law of the Old Testament. So even your own God believed in the Old Testament, but you don't.
And do you know what Jesus
said? Okay. Anyway, before I finish, let me finish the verse. God says, "Love God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your
mind, understanding, all your mind." All
so well, don't tell me not to use my mind, because that's what God advocates, and this is what God commands you to do.
I did not say that to you.
You keep saying you're using this.
No.
How many times have you said this now?
But it doesn't mean I'm telling you not to use your mind.
So what is it you're telling me?
I told you to have understanding in concept. Don't believe.
Look, I gave you the context. I gave you the context.
And I gave it to you.
You did not show me a single verse where God says that His love is unconditional. You haven't shown me anywhere.
You don't want to accept the truth.
What truth? You're saying it's from here.
Okay, can I talk? Second.
I let you talk so many times. And you haven't showed me evidence where God says His love is unconditional.